curious, I have to continue and discuss this about the weed out. Now the weed out is the moment when we are at, we have the, this group, you know, that is starting to enliven their brains, they're starting to be more like natural, more foods better for the planet, better for their bodies. And then we have the other group that is the factory farmed group, the group that eats from the factory farms, that won't change, that won't adapt, they won't modify. They are very, very held. Okay. I almost want to say, and then there's a third group, and that one is the one that stops us from concentrating. And that group is really annoying sometimes. They play castanets and they do things, and you just cannot listen, you can't hear your own brain think, you know, they're just interrupters. Okay, so we have that group. And they're, oddly, the interrupter groups can be on either side. They can join the factory farm group, or they can be with the vegan and naturalist Save the World group. Okay, so when we have this evolution occurring, where so many people want to be on the factory farm group, it's just like a really weird majority join, like chubby wub, that I don't understand. I don't understand how there could be like a network of my group, my belonging. I belong to the pig manure, poo lakes. I belong there. I want to have my picnic party there in the middle, build an island in the middle, where the blood-stained manure just relishes in this massive lake. I want to be there in the middle and have a picnic, right, direct from that factory farm, you know. So I'm like, well, okay, so our group, I'll say this naturalist group, is just like, no, that's wrong, we have to stop them, you know. And unfortunately, We are also the ones that are training ourselves to have less children and not be such gross overpopulators. But this factory farm group is a gross overpopulator. So we are being weeded out, okay? The naturalist group is being weeded out, and the factory farm group is, of the pig farm builders is on the increase. Okay, so we are like, no. We've got to change them. We have to change them, amend them. How do you amend their minds? How do you change them? When they're only talking from their taste buds. I like the way it tastes. I like the way the food tastes. I don't care how they suffered. I like how they taste. Okay, so this factory farm group, they are so much coward. They are absolute coward. They are coward to be individual. They are the majority. So because this majority is coward, oh, I can't make changes because she does and doesn't. I can't make changes because he doesn't. And they're in my network, you understand? He's the banker. He's the doctor. I cannot make changes. So I will even, you know, you have the men and the women that will even lick the manure from that pig sty. Because they are coward. They cannot make changes. They are so emphatic in their majority. Okay, meanwhile, this cute naturalist group is being weeded out. They're being weeded. And it's scary, because no, many of us don't have children. Many of us have just said no. Wrong. Absolute wrong. Planet cannot have any more. So while they're having their picnic, their 4th of July, in the middle of the pig manure lake, waiting for their feast, there's a line. You know, I see that line. I see that comedian who's making that in the cartoon. I see the line of the fair, of them lining up to go sit at that table and feast. I see that. I see those people. You know, lines from one city to the next. They are that much a majority, standing in line to go sit in the middle of the pig manure lake, just to have a picnic. Okay, so I want to say that they're stupid, but I cannot, because this majority is holding degrees and doctorates, and they went to college, and they did this, and they did that. And so they wheeled those around people. Look what I did. And so I fit in here, and my bank account is this, and doesn't matter, I'm in the majority. Okay, so they have the professional, we'll call them the professions, they have those, because they're holding the professions in majority. We are in trouble. If this weed out group, we're in trouble. So, I hate to say it, but the weed out group is oddly, they don't want to be professions, they don't want to. Many of the weed out group do not. This is our problem. They don't want to hold professions, they don't want to be lawyers and doctors and dentists and all of that above. They just want to be gurus like me. You know, they don't want to adhere because the system is so corrupt by those professions. It's so corrupt. You know, the medical profession is so corrupt in its want. It would rather have you sick. It is so corrupt. It would rather give you vaccines that make you ill with a chance of, rather than not. You know, this is the corruption group, and yet people they can't leave that group. They're cowards. So I don't understand it. So we're actually, you know, the brave selves, I'll call them the naturalists, the braves are like, what's going on? How could we be overrun by cowards that are destroying the planet? Anyway, so yeah, so I'm on the weed out. I'm trying to avoid being weeded out. How do you change the mind of a coward? You know, you can make silly sentiments in cartoons. We can really, really do the sway difference. You know, a fun woman, not fun at all. She wasn't fun at all, but she did twist my brain. She was somebody that I dormed with, and she had a fetish to only wear 1950s. You know, everything 1950s. You know, her shoes, her dresses, her hats, her purses, everything. And I was like, oh, she's the most infuriating human being on the planet. She was a dancer. And she went to her ballet school and I went to mine. But she was like into the fashion, into the vogue of it. And it was just something I just was like, you are just annoying. You know, you're just an annoyer. But in reality, she was that cartoon. She was being that cartoon. She was being that, ha ha ha, do we want to keep living it? You know, so some people do it that way. You know, they actually become the past accolade of devastation, walking down the street, you know, and I can imagine she had coupons in her purse for the soap and bubbles. You know, you can go that route, but I don't really know if that's helping. It's funny at the time, but I don't know if it's helping. Okay, so wake them up, wake them up, wake them up, you know. We're all like, yeah, wake up, everybody. That's not working because they have so much power. They have so much power by their doctors. Their doctors tell them what to do, you know. And because they live by their doctors' mantras, and they live by their lawyers, and they live by the government, you know, there is just not, there's not enough decline coming over. So it's how to approach that group, wake them up, twist the knives through their backs. What is wrong with them? You know, what is wrong with them? How can you wake up every day and not care about your surrounding? I don't understand it. How can you breathe the air of the planet and not care about your surrounding? I mean, it's an impossibility. One would think so. But the standardization that this majority group, this coward majority group, the standardization is so thick in their brain. It's so regimented. Okay. Then yeah, we're talking to an army. The naturists, the naturalists here are talking to an army. An army of cowards. Anyway, I gotta go.